Hey everybody! So today I'm going to be doing a look based on almost all Colourpop. some of the stuff I don't have because I have had the same thing forever that I just don't want to change, or they have things that I use, or they don't have things that I use all the time. So I have a lot of products from there. There's probably three or four products that I don't, which I guess we would say are kind of essentials, but I don't have them unfortunately. But I have some great products from Colourpop, and especially the No Filter Foundation, which everybody wants to hear about. So I think we're pretty 50-50 with what we have and what we don't, and makes up for it with what we do, because it's stuff that is new and it is important in the community. So I'm going to show you how to get this look, and I'm going to review the products while I'm doing it. So stay tuned if you want to have this look. So first I'm going to go in with the Colourpop No Filter Concealer. This is in the shade Medium 30. It's a little dark for me, but I'm just going to kind of work with it. I'm going to lighten it up with my other concealer. It's not Colourpop, but I'm just going to lighten it up a little bit. But for right now, I'm just going to cover the few spots that I have. So it covers pretty good, like, blemishes and dark spots, but under your eyes, it's probably going to be a little bit dark. Because it did cover well, but it is going to be dark under my eyes, so I'm going to have to lighten up under my eyes. So now I have two different shades of the Colourpop No Filter Foundation. I bought Fair 35 and Light 45, and I bought 35 first. It was a little too light, and then I bought 45, and I don't know, I still don't think this is the right color, but I think this is probably the best that it's gonna get, so we'll see. So I'm gonna shake it, pop it open. I'm gonna do two pumps. It's a pretty decent amount. Tends to crack around your mouth and nose, I was reading, so I'm gonna try to just cover those the best I can so they don't crack. So two pumps covered my whole face, which not a lot of foundations will do, so I think that's pretty cool, but we'll see how it lasts. So this is this side done. Go over my eyes. You can see it's a little light, but I could always bronze it up, so that's what I'm gonna end up doing. So this is what one coat looks like. I'm severely white. It's definitely too light still. I was hoping it was gonna be darker, but I am just gonna do like literally not even half a pump and just go over one more time on my problem areas. But for the most part, it is pretty full coverage. Like, it really covered my face. I honestly don't even need to do this probably, but it's just such a habit of doing, so I'm just gonna do it just in case, because I know I did read and see videos of it like cracking, so I don't want it to crack on my problem areas. So I'm sure everybody's different with where it's cracking and depending on your facial expressions and stuff, so I'm hoping that that doesn't happen to me at all, but if it does, definitely not in my problem areas. So okay, so now I'm gonna go in with the No Filter Concealer, and I'm just gonna do a little bit under my eyes. You could tell that like this is almost darker than my concealer, but for the sake of the video, I'm gonna roll with it. So I'm gonna bring it down here, and I'm gonna bring it across. It feels really lightweight. I feel like I'm really gonna like this, but obviously the color is not ideally what I would like. So I'm gonna go in with the Catrice Liquid Camouflage, I wouldn't say Colourpop is drugstore, but it's kind of, it's priced at drugstore range, so that's why I consider it like drugstore. So this is like a concealer I would use every day, so you could definitely see the difference in color with it, that it's really dark from what I normally use. So I'm just gonna blend it out and see what it looks like. I can always go back in and blend more of the lighter color in. Actually, it doesn't look that bad. So I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna blend my nose and up here. So I just went in with my loose setting powder, and I realized that you can't really see it, the powder. Usually like when I do my makeup, you can see it. So you can definitely tell that this powder is about the same color as the under eye concealer, but I'm not too upset with it. Like, you really can't see too many lines under my eyes, which I tend to struggle with when I'm trying to get my concealer to blend out and go well with the powder. And I think there's really no creasing under my eyes. So I definitely give that concealer a good rating, because that's hard for me to do, is to not get any creases. So that's really impressive that that concealer was able to do that. But now I'm going to go in with just my regular setting powder and bronzer, because I don't have any of them from Colourpop. So I'm just going to do that off camera and I'm going to come right back.
Okay, so big problem I just ran into when I was doing my blush is it got really patchy.
Literally two stripes, they got really patchy on the foundation. And it's not my setting powder, because I use it every single day. I'm going to wipe the excess off of my blush brush. I'm going to try to blend it out. Yikes. It's not moving. So, don't really know what the plan is from here, but I'm going to try to lightly blend. Maybe that'll make a difference. At least make it look not as harsh. Okay. So, I'm definitely going to blame the foundation on that problem right there, because it's the same blush and the same setting powder that I use every day, so it's not that either of those things seem to blend okay on the forehead. But I'm gonna go back in, I'm gonna try the other cheek, put more on there. This cheek always looks better with blush. It's just like that favorite eyebrow you have, like the same effect, but I look like a clown right now. Okay, so does not blend out nicely. The bronzer was fine, but the blush, almost like in my problem area where I applied more of the foundation, will not blend out. So I'm gonna go off camera and try to blend this more, and then I'll be right back.
My current situation, because it will not blend out, so I need to bake it away. I don't even know what I'm gonna do from here, but I'm gonna try to bake this so it's not as harsh, and I'll be right
okay,
back.
Okay, so baking it made a little bit of a difference. It doesn't look as harsh. So I would suggest that if you ever have a problem like that, or you feel like your blush or foundation, or I'm sorry, not foundation, your blush or your bronzer are not mixed, or not, wow, are not blending out, you could always bake into the shape that you want it to be. So I did it so it wasn't so harsh, and it's still, I think it just looks a little, it looks harsher on camera than it does right now in my mirror, but definitely not a look I was going for. So that's, I'm gonna 100% blame the foundation, because I used this one other time and I feel like I had the same problem. So I'm gonna go ahead and blame the foundation on that one. I'm also now gonna go in with the Colourpop Luster Dust, which is a loose highlighter. This color is Aurore. I've used this many, many times, and it's honestly one of my favorite colors. And I'm gonna go in with my Morphe M530. Looks like this. I'm going to dip into the top and take literally a little bit, and I'm gonna mix it into the cap. I'm just gonna mix it up here and take it up my temple. I'm gonna hit my nose a little bit up here, and then I'm gonna do the same thing with even less, because I still have a little bit left in the cap. And up the temple. Perfect. This is definitely one of my favorite highlighters I've ever used. You guys can see the glow. Okay, so before I do my eyes, I'm gonna go in and do my lips first, because they look kind of crazy. So I'm gonna go in with my NYX lip pencil. I'm just gonna line my lip. Now, I have a ton of different Colourpop ones, but I'm gonna go in with this ultra matte lip called Bianca. It's just a nice nude. I'm gonna dip a little bit back in. It's like a really perfect nude, almost like it was meant for me. So I have two Colourpop eyeshadow palettes that are my favorites. I have the QAF, also known as Yes Please, and I have the I Think I Love You palette. I'm just gonna show you the I Think I Love You palette, because I don't think I'm gonna use it today, but I don't really use it often. I noticed it was a lot of shimmer shades once I got it, and they really are pretty colors, but it's not what I want to use every day, and I'm genuinely obsessed with reds and oranges, so I'm gonna go ahead and use this one. And if you can't tell, I use this one all the time. It's literally so beat up, but it's probably one of my favorite, like, and especially go-to palettes. So I'm gonna create an eye look using the Yes Please palette, and I'm gonna grab some of my brushes.
I'm gonna go in with the shade Chauffeur, which is this brown right here, and I'm gonna be using that as my transition color. I don't know what the deal is with Colourpop eyeshadows, but they tend to literally just be the best eyeshadows on the market, in my opinion. They're not overpriced whatsoever, and they don't have fallout. Like, they just are always so consistent in their formula that I always will buy them if I like them. And granted, I try to cut down on eyeshadows now because I have so many. So, like, once I go through my collection, I'll probably buy some more. The first eyeshadow palette I bought in a while was the Norvina one. And probably the last one since that one was maybe the Galaxy palette from Fenty Beauty that I didn't buy. I got as a gift for Christmas. So I try not to buy them often because I have so many, and you can't even use that many. I don't care what anybody says, you cannot use that many at once. So that's my transition color laid. Again, I did that in a wiper motion. So now I'm gonna go in with my little bit of a stiffer brush. And I am going to go in with Louis. I'm going to do this towards the outside of my eye. I'm going to kind of start doing that into the shape of a cat eye. I always tell myself when I go into this palette that I'm going to use different colors, and then I always use the same colors. So I tried to do that with this too, and it didn't really work in my favor, so we're just gonna go with the same colors I use all the time because I love them. Okay, now I'm just gonna do the same thing to the other eye.
Okay, so I just did both eyes, and now I'm going to go in with this red shade called Butter Cake, which that doesn't really make much sense that red shade would be called Butter Cake, but it is, so I just double checked. Using my Real Techniques Duo Fiber Eye Brush, I'm going to kind of go in the crease of my eye with this red, kind of make it pop. I'm just gonna do some more. See how it kind of just pops right in your eye? I don't know if it's just like a personal thing or if it's my skin tone, but like reds and oranges look so good on me, and they're definitely like my favorites. I'm guessing probably because of that reason, but I just am obsessed, and I'm so glad I bought this palette, honestly. So I just did the red right there, and I'm gonna go ahead and do
that. So I also went ahead and went in with this yellow color called French Kiss, just to kind of lay it down. I think it's gonna make the sparkles pop more, even though it looks like McDonald's threw up on my eyes. I think it's going to help in the long run. So I'm going to take this orange called Note to Self. I'm just gonna take it in a little bit, and I'm gonna start to blend in the middle of my eye. Make sure you get the eye, like the liner. I'm sorry, I'm having problems talking today. The waterline of your eye, and kind of drag the excess out to the corner of your eye. So it kind of turned that orange into a little bit of yellow, which is what I was going for, so I'm really happy that I ended up putting that yellow down. Make sure you get your waterline. I'm just gonna put a little bit more down. So now I'm gonna go in with this gold shade right here called Spoiled. I'm gonna use a different finger. And I'm gonna go in the corner of my eye. And I'm gonna do the same thing to the other eye. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna drag it down to the bottom corner of my eye. And all I'm going to do now is take my Morphe M506. That's what had the yellow on it. And then I'm just gonna blend up here to make sure none of the sparkle is mixed in with that. Perfect. I'm going to do my lower lash line off camera. I'm going to be using that red again. So I'll
I just finished my face, and I did my eyebrows, and I did my lower lash line. I'm going to go ahead and take my Smashbox spray.
Just a little bit. And I'm going to let that dry, and I'm going to do my mascara.
Okay, so this is the finished look. I'm currently loving almost everything, especially the concealer. I'm super impressed that it hasn't creased underneath my eyes yet. Like I said, most of my concealers, especially my Shape Tape that I use every day, I notice that it creases and I can't do anything about it because I have tried everything and nothing will not crease. So this is enough to probably push me to go and order my actual shade in the concealer. This is definitely way too dark. I need to go way, way, way lighter. Probably not even in the mediums. Probably back to the lights. But that's probably something I'm going to be purchasing. I'm glad that I did this video to start using it again. Definitely super impressed as usual with the eyeshadows. I love the way this look came. This inner corner highlight came from the Colourpop I Think I Love You palette. And the shade was Rowdy. Is this one. Literally that was one dip and then I had to wipe it off because I got way too much because I did like one swirl. So beautiful, beautiful eyeshadow colors for such a reasonable price. The lip, I don't know if you can see that, kind of sticks a little bit, and that's my pet peeve. I don't know if it's just like a me thing, but I really don't like that. But it's not driving me crazy, but it's not something I'm crazy about, if you know what I'm saying. So I mean, I think this is the only ultra matte lipstick I have, and maybe that's why it's sticky, because it's ultra matte. Because what's this one? This one's ultra lip satin. So I think I've used this one before and I've noticed a difference. So these I don't think are going to be as matte and as sticky, because you could see the lines in my lips with this, and that's another pet peeve of mine. But I think that's a me thing. I think that they're good. The foundation really irks me because it looks beautiful on camera, it looks beautiful in the mirror. It truly does. I would give it right now, I'd give it like a 7 out of 10. It's really a great foundation. I worry though, because the blush, I don't know what happened over here earlier. I was able to fix it, but again, like for a beginner, like you wanna, of course a beginner is gonna buy a $12 foundation. Nobody's gonna wanna go spend thousands of dollars on makeup. If they use this foundation and they see that it's not blending, or they don't notice that that's not how blush is supposed to be, I worry. Because I don't know, I'm not even gonna blame my blush. I almost just blamed it to make me feel better, but it's not. It's the foundation, I think. It's not the setting powder I've used it. It's not the blush. I use it every day. But that was really the only problem I had with it. It has not cracked, and it actually did not leave dry patches under here, which my foundation normally does. So I'm gonna let it sit, and in the bio, I'm gonna go actually outside and go like do something for like an hour. So I'm gonna come back and see, and I'm gonna write in the bio if it's cracked or where it's cracked and if it did anything. So I'm gonna update you on that. And also I noticed the concealer did a good job of covering those two pimples, as did the foundation. So I'm pretty impressed overall. I'm glad I gave the foundation a second try, and I'm super glad I gave the concealer a try, because it was way away. Like I was never using it again because it was way too dark. But I'm definitely going to order my shade in that, and I hope you liked everything. If you liked this video, please feel free to like it and subscribe. And if you have any comments, just leave them down below. And make sure you follow my Instagram page at makeupdoneby_Bianca. Thank you.